oh, okay. Yeah, I let me say it again.
La, 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 la.
Get out your white suit, your tap shoes and tails. Put it in backward when forward fails. But leave Greta Garbo alone. Be a movie star.
You have any? You have any news?
I got a lot of news.
No, daily news.
Oh, the daily. Oh, yeah.
Is that the Brooklyn edition?
That's all they make now. Is one edition.
Only one edition. All right.
Read one, read all.
Okay, I'll take the one issue, one copy of the daily news, and I got the potato chips, and you got a pack of matches.
Wait a minute. I'm the type of person, you want some, you gotta let me know. All at once. Or you could do me a favor. There's another store down the block. Here, I'll even give you the money to go. Do me a favor. Go down there.
All right, I'll take the money.
I know it. Anything else I could do to make you happy?
I would like a chalk with ice cream.
You really would?
I really would.
I'd like one myself, but
I guess that wasn't.
I'll make you a special.
Two straws and one ice cream.
Two straws and one. You're in the wrong straw. You're in the wrong store. Because you're lucky you're going to get one straw.
Hi, this is Bruce Friedman for That's Brooklyn. And once again, we found a place that you could not find anywhere but in Brooklyn. And that is Joe's Luncheonette on the corner of 66th Street and 15th Avenue, right under the beautiful elevator subway line. So if you hear noise in the background, you know that's the reason. You see, I drive around Brooklyn looking for a good place to get a chocolate egg cream. That's the truth. And sometimes it's sort of sad because the only way you could get a chocolate egg cream is if it comes in a can and you have to shake it up, you know?
That's horrible. You can't make an egg cream unless you make your own seltzer. The pressure is not enough on these other units. That's different why I can make an egg cream, a lot of stores can't. It's the pressure that I have when making the egg cream. That's why you will get a head on the egg cream here. Mm-hmm. A lot of times you get like a flat beer, you know, with no head. It looks like the suds are just laying on top waiting to die.
Well, why is it if I were to go into a bar and wanted a beer, they would wipe the head off the beer. But with an egg cream, that's the best part. You want to get that foam.
Well, the secret to making a good egg cream is everything has to be cold. A lot of, there's tricks to this that I'm helping some people out that are opening a business in Jersey. They invest a lot of money. And they came in and I felt so bad for them. I'm giving them my time to show them how to make the stuff and the way it was made years ago. And they love it. They're buying my, they're gonna call it Uncle Joe's Old Fashioned Egg Cream.
Really?
It's true.
Now, who's this guy pictured on the t-shirt?
You mean the movie actor?
Yeah, yeah.
That's me.
That's you.
That's me.
Is that the same guy over here?
I think I look better over here than over there.
Did somebody ever say to you, don't put your back to the camera?
No, nobody.
Well, I'd like to ask you to put your back to the camera because I'd like to see the back of the shirt.
Okay, no All problem.
Right. Let me see the back. Here we go. It says Brooklyn's Best Egg Cream, 1930 to 1997. Now, you see, that's kind of funny because in 1929, the October 30th, 1929, the stock market crashed, and then the country went into a depression. Unless you came to Joe's Luncheonette, there was no depression here, because you could get a cherry Coke, handmade, fresh homemade seltzer, an egg cream, a malted.
The ice cream, we used to sell tons of packed ice cream, you know, the ones they used to do. I mean, we had to start an hour early. People used to come in, they loved it.
Does that mean you made it here?
No, we didn't make it here, but we at one time, and we sold a lot of ice cream. A lot. We used to have a couple of ice cream freezers. Everything has changed. People now, everything has to be quick. You know, let's go to McDonald's, go to Carvel. They don't want to wait and sit down for anything. They're rushing their life. They want to die faster, so they rush faster to me. It's just the way it sounds.
Well, you mentioned the 60s being your favorite time.
Oh, that's terrific.
I want to know about New Utrecht High School, which is right in the neighborhood.
And that is still a very good school in New Utrecht. It was very good in sports. They had an old place there, Chucky's Luncheonette, but he was only there 45 years, so he's like a baby next to me. Ran out six, but it was very nice. Italian and Jewish students mostly when I went.
Now, another big landmark in Bensonhurst, of course, is the Lowe's Oriental Theater. Now, we know it's closed, but it's not forgotten.
No, I went to the movies there a few times with different girls, and it was nice. You know, it's people didn't smoke pot in the back or, you know, throw things at you and stuff like that. And years ago, people just sat down and enjoyed what they had come to see, not to cause a scene.
You know what makes me laugh about the old theaters? Something like the Lowe's Oriental had about 3,000 seats, and they came to see one movie. All the people came to see the same movie at the same time.
Yes.
Right? Now, instead of a beautiful starlit sky, you know, maybe what they called an atmospheric, or without the beauty we used to have with the ornate plaster work and the
statues,
carving and the statues, right? Now we've got concrete shoeboxes, okay? And they show 10 movies to an audience of 100 people in each theater. And whatever happened to the movie palaces? Now, what's this garbage I hear about you closing this place?
I'm getting old. Well, it boiled down that I'm selling the building. Plus, I've been here, I was born into the business, and our family's here 68 years. And the brain works, but the body's not following it anymore.
Now, when you say that you were born here, I understand from talking to your wife earlier that you used to sort of curl up and fall asleep in one of the booths over
right
there.
When I was small, we used to be open till 1, 2 in the morning, and my mother and father worked here, and I would sleep in the boot, and they picked me up at the end of the day, like when I was 1, 2 years old, and they put me to sleep. So I was really born into this business.
You know something? It's important for all the people around here that grew up with Joe's Luncheonette. It's also important for all the people that lived here, grew up here, and moved away. Because no matter where they go, this is where it all started.
I've had people coming back since this has happened to me. They've been coming from Jersey, Long Island. People just love the old stuff, especially the egg creams, the old found, the old boots, memories. You walk in here and just all that, memory lane.
You know, when you mention memory lane, I grew up in East Flatbush, and on East 43rd Street and Church Avenue was Dave and Jean's Luncheonette. It was a candy store Luncheonette just like this. And their last name was Hoffman. So naturally they featured Hoffman soda. And every so often, I pass by and I park the car and I sit there. It's all boarded up. The door has got cinder blocks right up to the top. It's rusted away, you know, the metal gates. But I could picture it like it was yesterday.
Well, it's funny. People have been saying for years, why don't you fix this, fix that? Why don't you do that? And I never did it. And now I'm finally going out of business. Everybody loves this.